My name is Max Kordek, CEO and co-founder of Lisk and director of Lightcurve here in Berlin. I'm going to speak for 5 minutes only, so it's going to be super fast. It just should inspire you to join blockchain, and it should not give too many deep information. So my topic of today is evolution of UI UX in blockchain. And because we are on a React Native conference, I thought I'm going to talk about wallets. That means the user interfaces of how you can access your cryptocurrencies. As a quick disclaimer, I don't want to attack any other wallets. I don't want to discredit them or anything like that. I just want to talk objectively, and I'm showing wallets which are quite old sometimes. Today, they might look entirely different. So it all started 2011 with Bitcoin. Here we see the original Bitcoin wallet developed by the original team of it. It's native in C++ using the Qt framework, and it's beautiful, isn't it? It's amazing, and it all started with that. But as you probably see, it's not really a user interface normal people can interact with once you have to download over 100 gigabytes of the blockchain data, and it's just Bitcoin. You have to install something. It's not really nice. So it went on with, in the next year, another one which was focused on security. And here it's really interesting that for the first time ever, there was a third-party wallet not developed by the original developers. That means here people started to trust other developers that they not steal their Bitcoin. This basically kick-started it all, this further development of better wallets. And the next step basically was to go to a new platform, to the mobile platform. Here we see Mycelium, which looks not that beautiful at that time. Today it's much, much better, but it was a first try to bring blockchain technology and your cryptocurrencies to a mobile platform. Of course, you cannot download 100 gigabytes of data onto your phone, especially not 2013. So they were one of the first ones who implemented something called a light client. That means you're just accessing directly the network and don't have to download the data yourself. Then the famous Ethereum wallet in 2015, which was one of the first ones using JavaScript, unfortunately Meteor at that time. And here we have one which was not developed for Bitcoin, but for an altcoin. That means it started that other cryptocurrencies are being developed independently from the Bitcoin community, and independent teams are starting to disrupt, are trying to innovate the user experience. But as you see, still super minimal with just one goal in mind, transferring tokens. The next step then was to bring it online, to bring the user interfaces to access your cryptocurrencies to a website, which was, like for example, developed by blockchain.info, today blockchain.com, which of course brings an ease of use, but it's also a significant security problem because, well, someone can hijack the domain, can hijack the connection, and just be the man in the middle stealing all your cryptocurrencies. But I think it's a very important movement to just further try to make it easier to use cryptocurrencies. 2017, then people started to really realize, okay, hey, it's about user experience. We need designers on board. We need a full dedicated team to make this happen. And here with Exodus, we had one of the first companies, one of the first startups, really focusing just on that. They don't develop any cryptocurrency or whatever. They just develop this wallet to make it as easy as possible. And in order to attract as many users as possible, they implemented all kinds of cryptocurrencies. So here we have a wallet which was a business or a startup, and a wallet which combined probably 20, 30 different currencies to attract the masses. In 2018 now, we have like all kinds of different developments happening. I think 2018 was one of the best in terms of progress on the technological side. And these wallets are now shaping up to be really powerful tools, not only to transfer a token, but really to be part of an entire ecosystem. And most cryptocurrencies, of course, provide a wallet for desktop and for the mobile platforms. And they want to go so far that users are using them on an everyday basis. So they now have to think about how to get the user into the wallet, even though they're not wanting to transfer tokens. So With that, I just wanted to show you really quick in a few minutes the evolution of cryptocurrency user interfaces and how it's really shaping up to become a usable platform. And if you want to know more about it, I can just tell you you should become part of this, actually. We have a booth here, and my team is happy to answer all your questions. We're using React. We're using React Native. I think it's the perfect conference for us to be here and tell you more about our user interfaces and how we shape the future of blockchain user experience. Thank you very much.